Truth be told, I've been grooming for this since birth. Kind of in some ways like the Einstein story, although I wasn't sent home, school is completely ineducable. And his mother made up a story to tell him what a genius he was, and then made him a genius through the power of positive thinking. But I was sent home with reprimands or grades that I wasn't paying attention, or I was too distracted, or I might be this, or I might be that. They tested me for everything as a child. They tested hearing, they tested audio, video, perception of blocks, every test imaginable. Only to find that I excelled at anything I applied myself to. But when distracted by life's hardships of domestic violence, tragedies, deaths, questionable tragedies, and others, even as a child you can lose focus. But as a young child I remember reading presidents and heads of nations, senators, governors, attorney generals, Secret Service, FBI, military, Black Panthers, DOD, UAW, didn't matter. Leaders of industry, leaders of government, leaders of religion, leaders of persuasion. I met geniuses as a child. I was blessed to be sent to Interlaken, the fine arts, Lake Superior State University, to Lansing, Michigan for electoral information and Senate College stuff, and war colleges, and even have been to NORAD at age 16, 5 feet under, our command center for attacks. I have been in military installations, I've traveled on military ships, military crafts. I have done secret missions for my country and for domestic and foreign affairs as a child. My first deployment, unbeknownst to me, aside from the ones with the FBI and Secret Service, you know, as a teenager. Big memorable out-of-country experience was when I was 19 on a fact-finding mission with the CIA for the White House and ABC News. And when I realized what I had walked into at 19, I nearly lost my life on landing and released to machine guns, machetes, and people ripping my shit apart, and I'm going, hold on, I'm with ABC, and somebody tapping on my shoulder said, I'm with the CIA, be quiet, I'll get you out of here alive. They started packing my stuff up like I was in a 5-star hotel when he said he's with me. And escorted us out to the vehicle waiting, and 20 minutes of ride, it was silence. I finally said, it was a fucking bright idea, was this deployment. So he had already had things with governments before that, Secret Service, U.S. Marshals, ATF, pick an agency, even DEA. Because I was the kid who was covering hard news at age 10 and was a steering for ABC, AP, UPI, Reuters, World Television News, had 12 television stations, network affiliates to uplink with, as well as 24 more local radio stations, and when I had a news story from 10 to 16 or through life, those were my core starting wire services, networks, internationally, domestically, press to newspapers. I could hit the world by hitting those wire services through television, film, documentaries, with stories that I have leaked over the years. Not always under my name, sometimes under Edward James, sometimes under Anonymous, sometimes under Live Video Wing, sometimes under testified before the Senate Subcommittee hearing and had not found his underground dump and downs and threatened to take everybody to them in underground D.C. and New York and other locations. I've dealt with military police cartels, El Chapo, the recent punkish who sent to Venice Beach is an asshole and he's going to get his arms cut off by somebody being the dumb shit he was with me. Let me just say this about that. And it won't be me that'll be doing it. He'll piss off a lakeshore person and he will be swimming with sharks, so you might want to pull your chopper off the beach. Wow. Jorge, Hank. I mean, major players in the cartel industry. I know personally. Their families. Dons. Mafia people. When you play at the level I play, with kings and queens and come from royalty and our third generation Camelot to the Kennedys, a third cousin through lineage related to Murphys and Cannells and Cronins and Johnstons and Gardeners and Lords and Knights of the Round Table and people who through history are real life characters in your family. I realized from birth, as I was told, I was the golden child, the golden boy. I was here for a mission. I knew that I was here to save fallen angels. I never couldn't do it through religion, couldn't do it through entertainment alone. Had to be involved in government, whether I liked it or not. Politics, diplomacy, humanitarianism, philanthropic endeavors, a long list of research and science and technology, and I have to learn as much as I could about everything. I was like a little scientist as a kid, blowing things up, rocket, launching the rockets out of the backyard, studying JPL in Life and Time magazines, reading Botanica encyclopedias, absorbing as much as I could, hack the Library of Congress. Not really, because I had the passcodes from presidents and assistants when they needed federal law pulled down, but I had my Radio Shack stuff that I was using on dial-up phones, and couplers and recorders and other things that I had, or teletypes, to transmit over rotary phone lines into Library of Congress to pull down codes. I also knew how to put them up, and they didn't like, you know, someone rewriting federal law, especially since Mom had always told me as a chairman of the Democratic Party was always written to a high-level sixth grade education, which I more than had. I excelled, and while I did okay in grade school and high school, I was already taking college classes from childhood and accelerated classes beyond that as a teenager. So I wasn't really focused on, but when I went back to college as an adult, I turned that all around. When I really focused and applied, it didn't matter if it was math, science, geometry, rocket science, coding, decrypting, whatever. On the terrorism negotiation, hostage negotiation. Find and rescue situation. I mean, there's nothing I haven't encountered in life as an entertainer, as a federal contractor, as a humanitarian, as a philanthropist, as a high-level scientist, as a research and developer, as high-level intel, cleared a majestic crypto for international work and domestic work with foreign, state, local, and federal governments, Interpol, it doesn't matter. The one thing they all know, whether they like what I give them or not, and usually it's not, let's be honest, is that when I call a situation, it's usually spot on. I'm really good at logistics, statistics, collateral damage, burden of load of cost. Pick a category. There's a reason by 1999 I was worth privately billions of dollars. And with the code I had developed, it was projected to be worth trillions of dollars in less than half a decade. There's a reason why my government and others conspired to overthrow my companies and bankrupt that company through Lockheed Marietta, through DOD, through Tom Neitzel, through Karen Neitzel, through the Bush administration, through Ed Muchmore, through Microsoft, through, oh my God, the Chilenes, the list is fucking long, through Bill Shea of Shea Stadium. I know some of the biggest